Hello coders, welcome to yet another exciting lesson on JavaScript. Today we are going to be discussing JavaScript form validation. And normally you know we have always been writing the code alongside the lesson, but today the code has already been written, so we are just going to explain the code to save time, because it's going to take quite some time to type the code out. So to save time, we are going to just explain the code. Trust me, it's quite easy. It's not something you need to be scared about, so it's very easy. We are just going to explain right about now. Okay, so first of all, remember that our folder, right, that our special folder we created is our JavaScript folder. So what we did was that we created another HTML file, and that HTML file, that is where the user will be redirected to after successfully filling the form. And so this is a picture, like, well, just a mere picture that we'll add to this HTML file. So before we go to explaining the code, let us try to know what form validation is. Form validation is just basically ensuring that the user has filled the form in the correct manner, following the fill in short. Yes, that's just a basic summary of it. Filling the form in the correct manner. And the correct manner might involve filling the required fields, form fields, or inputting the correct data types. And we look at the two. First, this is the first case. And for the second case, we are going to take the case of an email. Like, you input the correct email. So for this case, we are just looking at making sure that the user fills the name and the password in the correct manner. Like, the name is a required field, the password is a required field. So they have to fill the name and the password. So if the person doesn't fill the name, the page is going to keep on reminding the person, no, the name cannot be empty, the person needs to fill. If you fill the password that is less than 6 characters, the page will keep on alerting to you that no, you need to fill a password greater than 6 characters, or that the password must be, yes, greater than 6 characters long. So those are the two main types of form validation methods. You have the basic validation and the data format validation. The basic is just this filling, making sure that you have filled all the mandatory fields in the form. And then data format validation ensures that you have filled the correct data type. In the case for emails, you ensure that you have filled the correct email. In the case of a phone number, ensure that you have filled the correct phone number, and so on. So for this first method, you recall forms in HTML, right? So this is just basically the forms in the normal forms in HTML you know about. So here's just a header, and then the form, you name the form. This is the form name, and that's what we are going to be using. We are going to access this form name alongside our code. So this is my form. Then the action actually tells you what should be done or where the user should be redirected after the submit button has been clicked. That means after the form has been filled and the submit button clicked, this is where the user should be redirected, which is this success.html that we created. Let us open it and see what. See the content. You see, this is the success.html. So we just have a text, congratulations, of a text of header one, congratulations, form successfully validated. Then we added this our success image, the one I showed you in the folder, right? And then we have restricted the height and the width, just basic CSS. So just style it here. So that's just it. The action of the form tells you where the user should be redirected after the form has been filled and submitted. Then the onSubmit shows you the action that it should be, that should be running, like that you keep on running, like as long as you are filling the form, as you are filling the form, what should be happening. So this is what this means. It should return this. This validate form is a function that we have written in our script tag here. So this is just like, it's just, it keeps on running so long as you are filling, as you are filling the form, this is running. So onSubmit, as you fill the form and you submit, You should first of all run a test, and then this action now redirects you to the find after you have successfully. But here is on submit. When you are just hitting the submit button, what should happen first before you are redirected to this one? So we have just two fields. We have the name field and then input type text name. We have just named it, and this break tag just to give a space between these two fields, and the password input type password name password, just yeah, then you put a break tag. I think we should put another break tag, so I should, you should have a space between the button and, okay, let's save that. So you should have a space between the button, the submit button, and the password input field. So input submit value register. So this value is what will be written on the button. What is written on the button? Let's refresh that. You see register. This is a register, and this is the register here, the value. So the value is what is written on the button. Then the submit type, submit. Normally the HTML recognizes this as a button. Submit is usually a button. So, and the submit, you can even input type button, then you put value submit, or type submit, you still work. So this is just the form, the simple form we have created. Now let's move to our first type of form validation that we do. We do basic validation. So this is just basic validation, and with basic validation we are checking to see that the user has inputted the required fields. For now, these two fields are required. You need to fill the two fields in the appropriate manner. So we begin with the name function validate. This is how to declare function normally. So var name, so these are variables, the name and password. So and the name, the variable name, we have accessed the my form. You see, we have made use of this my form. We have accessed this my form dot name. Dot name, what is the name? Name dot value. So the value of this name, this name, what is written in this name? So we're accessing what is written in this name, and that's, and it's stored under the name variable. So document dot my form dot name dot value, we have accessed this. So we have begin accessing from the parent, that is my form, gone to name, and then the value, the value, since it's an input, so the value depend on what the user has given. So it's same with the password, document dot my form dot password, that's the name here, password, this name password dot value. So all that will depend on what the user will input. So it has accessed this HTML, this form element from here, and store them in some particular values so I can make use of them in JavaScript. Now we are giving ourselves a condition. If the name equals to null, that means if nothing is filled in the name, or name equal to an empty string, this is just a double quote with an empty string here, nothing filling. So if it is null, or you have an empty string, you should alert the message what name can't be blank. So that's just it, and then you return the value false. You know, normally for this to be valid, it has to be true. So if this happens, you return the value false, and then the form will not be submitted. On submit, you will not be submitted. You fail at that level. Then else if we have two conditions. If password length, password dot length, password dot length, this is like password dot, this password we are inputting, so the type we are inputting, the password dot length, if the length of the password is less than 6 characters, you should alert password must be at least 6 characters long, and then it return a false value. Therefore this will just fail at this level. It will just fail. It cannot perform this action. So it's just going to fail at the on submit. As you are submitting, you check, do this check. If there's nothing filled in the name, and then the password is less than 6 characters, it's going to fail at that level, and then return a false. So the form will just be there again, not filled, waiting for another input for you to try again. So I think enough of the explanation. Let's see how the code works. I'm sure that is very, very clear right now. So like, let's put a test now. Let's just fill, or let's not fill a name, let's fill a password instead. Well, let's just fill it. Yeah, anything on the password register. You see, name can't be blank. Okay, name can't be blank. Let's try another, the other scenario where the password is less than, or less, yeah, where the password is less than 6 characters. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, let's just input a name, anything, or let's say JavaScript, or let's say tricoder. Register. You see, password must be at least 6 characters long. So for this form to be successfully filled, then there must be a name and the password must be greater than 6 characters. Let's just input anything. That's obviously greater than 6 characters. So let's click on a register button and see what happens. There you have it. Congratulations, form successfully validated. So what has just happened is that once it has passed this test, the action now takes place, and that action directs you to this web page that we created, the success.html, and it just simply contains this text and this image that we added. So that is just basic form validation. That's basic form validation. Now we are going to the next type of form validation, known as data format validation. We'll make use of the data format. So this is a pre-written code. Let's just we are going to explain as time goes by. Let's just take the form and let's copy that. We have to replace all of this. Oh no, let's replace from this form here. Yeah, so this is the form, the script. I think let's put the script below. Let's put the script below the form. Remember in our previous lesson why I said it's advisable to put the script below. So here we have the body. I think we should get rid of this. So the action, our action is success.html. You see, then the onSubmit return validate email. This is a new function. Let's save that first. So this one is just a very easy, just a very simple form, just inputting email. We are just trying to demonstrate that of an email. So we are inputting the email, input type text, name, email. Normally in HTML forms, when you are inputting an email, the type is usually an email. But for demonstration purposes, that means we really want to use JavaScript to demonstrate that. We use the type text and then you just give a name, email. So here it doesn't consider it as an email, just a normal text. Yes, it's just a normal text as of now. So the input submit value, this is just a submit, just to submit. Okay, I think we should add another breaking tag here, so I should move to the next line again. So I should give some little space, save that. So input submit value register, so it still has a register. So let's refresh the page to see. Let's go back and refresh email. You see, you have just the email. So, and the action is still success. The success. Let's enter the success. Let's change something like email verified. Email verified. Let's save that. So I've changed the text to email verified. Congratulations, email verified. So we're going to let's save that. Save save this. So we have a value, a type submit value register. Then this is our form. This is our form. Our form ends here. So our form begins here and then ends here. This is just a simple form. So you know what the onSubmit means, right? So as soon as you click on the onSubmit, it should run this function before, when it passes this test, then the action should now be taking place. It should now happen. So the what does our function say? We create a variable x. The x, you can name it anything you want to. And that element is document.myform.email.value. So it has accessed this my form using this name my form. So that's the use of this name. When you type the name, it makes use of the name when you want to access it. Type is the name dot my is document dot, since it's a document, it's in a document, so it's document dot my form dot email, this name email dot value. So the value of that email, so that's stored in the value, in the variable x. We then create another variable at position to take note of the position x dot So x dot, so we, after accessing this in this value, this document dot, this is stored in this variable x. So from that x dot index of, we are looking for the index, that means the index position of this symbol, you know, this email symbol, right? I usually type like you have a email at, or you have info at gmail.com or something. Ads is just the at sign, so it's used for an email address. It's just basically used an email address, the at sign. So you have, for example, javascript at gmail.com, javascript at tricoder.com, you have info at tricoder.com, you have. So this at is just basically what we use in emails. So you have x dot, use the x dot, and this dot, you see us using dots quite often, right? This is what we call object oriented programming. Anyway, you can do more research on that, so you can have an idea of what we are talking about. So we do an x dot index of, to get the index of this and store it in this variable. So that is literally keeping track of the position of this at symbol. Then var dot position, so we are keeping track of this position and then this dot position. X dot last index of, what does this last index of do? So basically the last index of do, the last index of it works in the following way. The last index, it returns the position of the last occurrence of a specific value in the string. So the last index of, it returns the last occurrence of the dot. Because now there are some emails where you have like, you have quite a lot of dots. Like you may have javascript.tricoder.com, javascript.tricoder@gmail.com, something like that. So you have two dots, so you are keeping track of the last dot, and that last dot will determine what, where they will determine the position of this at symbol. So that's just it. We are keeping track of the last dot position to know where this at symbol is supposed to be. Because like I've just quoted the example, there are some emails where you have multiple dots, so we cannot just say the position of any, the first dot or any dot. We need to keep track of the last dot. So if at position, this at symbol, if the at position is less than one, or the dot position is less than or before at the add position plus two, like it's two times below the add position, like it's two times, twice as like the position of the dot is two times less than that than the add position, or the dot position type plus two string length, this is string length, sorry, is greater than the x dot length. So if the dot position plus 2 is greater than or equal to x dot length, the length of the email value. So if the dot position is more than, in short, this is just saying if the dot position is more than, greater than or equal to the length of the email value, that means the email value that I have inputted. So if the dot position is greater than that, you should alert, please enter a valid email address, because it cannot be greater than or equal to that, right? The dot needs to be like, if you look at emails, you have something like some javascript at gmail.com or at something.com. So the dot position cannot be equal to the length of that string, because the length will probably show you the position of that, so it cannot be greater than the length, right? So you alert that, and then in enter value image in, and then you return the position where you are supposed to input the dot, where you are supposed to put the dot, and so on. So, and then you return the false value. So that's, and then the form will just end from there. Let us save that and try to see how it works. Let's refresh again. Something at, sorry, at register, please enter a valid email address at position 6 dot position -1. You see, So the dot position needs to be here. Negative 1 means counting from here. This is 0, 1. So it needs to be somewhere here. So it means our email is invalid. This is data format validation. You see, our email is not in the correct format. So it prompts us to input the correct format of the data. And our data here is the email. Let's take a look at the code again to better understand. If this dot position, at position, if it is less than 1, that means if the at position is at position 0, that is, you have this at here. Let's do it and you see. Okay, let's refresh the page. So if the at position, you just have something at. Oops, what's going on? Let's refresh the page. So you have something like just at. It doesn't even work. Oh, what's going on? Okay. If you have something like just the at dot com, let's see if that will work. You see, it doesn't work because you cannot have an email with just beginning with at. And that is what this line does. It checks at position is less than 1. So it must be greater than 1. It must be greater than 1. That means it must belong at position. Position with index 1 or greater than 1. It cannot belong at position with index 0. It cannot belong at position 0. So that's why this first check is valid. So if dot position is less than at position plus 2, let's see. If dot position is less than at position plus 2, at position, this is at position plus 2, 1, 2. Let's say something at, let's say at position plus 2, plus 2 strings. So at position plus 1, plus 2. Or if it's less than that, let's say at this.com. Let's see how it works. Oops, okay, that one says congratulations. At position plus 2. At position plus 2, at the position index of this. So plus 2. At position plus 1, 2. Okay. I see the point now. Let's put it this way. It's 1. So if it's less than that, it's less than that, right? Oops, sorry about that. Let's register. Enter an email, a valid email. Let's see the code, see what it does actually. Here, if the dot position is less than at position plus 2, that means from the at position, 2 positions after that, if it is less than 2 positions after that, it is going to be invalid. That's one of the conditions for us to check this if. Like if you see here, this is position. This is the at position, right? So 2 positions to the right, you have 1, is at position 1, then 2. Formerly it worked because it was at position 2 and it was not less than position 2. Now it is less than position 2. So it is invalid. So we cannot have at.com. It's not reasonable, right? So when if we input something like A, so after this add you have position 1, 2. Is at position 2, register, it can work. That's an email, valid email, right? So let's test the third method and have an explanation. If dot position plus 2 is greater than or equal to the length of the email, this x is the document my form email value, it accesses the email value. So if it is greater than or equal to this email value, if it's greater than the email value, it is going to is equal to the length of that email value, it's an invalid email. So let's try. So at dot com, let's just say dot com. They say if that plus 2 1 2 is greater than or equal to the length of the string. So if this is greater than, if this is the length of the string, let's see. Okay, it works because this is equal to 2. It's equal to 2. Let's put it at 1, register, boom, you have it. Enter an email, a valid email address. So here it has to be, if it is greater than or equal to the length of the string, If the dot position plus two string plus two positions is greater than or equal to the length of the string, that means here after the dot position you have one, you have two. So this can only work if you have what's going on? Okay. Okay. Let's see something. Okay. What it does is that if it's actually, let's say you input something like this at this dot co, it can only be valid, the email can only be valid if the number of string characters after this is either 2 or greater than 2. If it's less than 2, that's why you have it here. If dot position plus 2 strings ahead is greater than or equal to the length of the whole email, you see, right? So greater than or equal to the length of the whole email, that would be another condition for making it invalid. Like if you have here just one register, it cannot be that, right? So that's just it guys. And now let's input a valid email. You have info@, let's say, tricoder.com register. Congratulations, email verified. Guys, that has been it, and I hope this was really, really, really exciting. Like, it's very exciting. Very, very exciting. So this has been it for form validation. There's a lot more you can do with forms. Just go out there, guys, and explore, do a lot of research. And thanks for watching. Thank you so much. And please don't forget to subscribe, like, share, comment. See you in the next lesson. Bye for now.